Hello everyone, this is ACHAIA Akaya bringing you another shoutcast to the StarCraft II beta. This is actually a game that has been played in the Nations Cup, and this is a game between HasuObs and Dimaga. And I have heard of both of these players, and they are apparently both high quality players, although I've only seen HasuObs actually play a couple games. But he is a very good player. Down in the bottom middle here, we have Dimaga spawning as the red Zerg, and in the mid right here, the yellow Protoss, going to be HasuObs. I'm just going to refer to him as Obs from now on, or actually Hasu would probably be easier to say. So yeah, I'm going to call him Hasu, just because HasuObs is a little bit long-winded, I think. Anyways, this game is very, very epic from what everyone has told me. So I wanted to cast it. I know that Husky has already put up a cast of this game. He got to it before I did. But if you've seen his cast and would like another perspective, or even if you haven't seen his cast and are just checking mine out, thank you for doing so. And hopefully you guys will enjoy this game. Like I said, I've heard it's pretty epic. So we should see a lot of cool strategies and some high-level play here, I would think, since both of these players are rated pretty highly. And we do have a gateway going up at the entrance for Hasu. He is going to be getting his gateway at 11, which is pretty typical for a Protoss player. And again, narrowing down the choke on his ramp by building that pylon and gateway initially at his entrance. And in case you didn't notice, this game is being played on Lost Temple, the new Lost Temple for StarCraft 2. Again, slightly different from Lost Temple of StarCraft 1, but very, very similar overall. And of course, one of the most important things of this new map here is to control these Zelnaga watchtowers as much as possible, because that gives you a huge area of vision throughout the whole middle of the map, so you will have a very, very good eye on what's going on as far as ground forces here. And it looks like a little bit of a later spawning pool here coming out, so we'll see what goes on. Usually, if you go to 14 or 15 drones before putting down a building, it's usually going to be a hatchery at the natural. So we'll see how that plays out here for Dimaga. Of course, he knows what he's doing, so I'm not going to question him. But anyways, spawning pool just finishing up here, so I would expect a queen to pop up here in his production here shortly. In the production menu, see, not a whole lot going on here. There is one zealot, and actually another hatchery going down. So he did go for the spawning pool first, but going for the hatchery second. And the probe of Hasu is already out here and bringing out a zealot actually as well. So going to put on some really early pressure. And it looks like there is another zealot coming down here too. So it looks like Dimaga is going to have to respond pretty quickly here. He does have six zerglings already, but zealots are much, much stronger against zerglings in StarCraft 2. So six zerglings may have been enough in StarCraft 1 if they were microed properly, but in StarCraft 2 they're not. You can see Dimaga bringing up some more drones to try to help out, and another zealot coming up just as the first one goes down. The second one very low on health, only about 20 HP, and all of his shields are gone, although since he is running away, those will regenerate here shortly. His first queen coming out now and throwing down some extra larva on his first hatchery, and it looks like he is going to be sending his queen out to his second hatchery so that he can spawn some larva on that once that hatches. Back at Hasu's base, he does have his first gas going and getting a cybernetis core, so beginning to tech a little bit further into the game, and you can already see that he's starting to spread some pylons out throughout his base. Now, the reason he is putting these pylons a little bit further out around the outskirts of his base is because they give him eyes around the whole area of his base. Because in StarCraft 2, I'm sorry, hold that thought, there is another battle going on here. The queen getting involved as well. These zealots getting microed against with some high speed zerglings here. Although I don't think the speedling upgrade has been researched yet. And two zealots going down, the third one very low on health. He's going to have to back off, and more zerglings coming from Dimaga. So Dimaga able to hold that off with relative ease, it seems, once he got his queen in the mix, and it looks like these zerglings are going to pursue back to Hasu's base. And Hasu now putting down a cannon and also has a forge. So, and with three zealots on the ramp, these zerglings are not going to be able to get him, especially since they do not have the speed upgrade yet. Now we do see an early Stargate here coming from Hasu, so he may be trying to get out an early Void Ray, although I gotta think that this Overlord has seen that Stargate go down, so he may already be aware. Let's take a look at the vision. Yeah, and he has seen it. I don't know if he clicked on it, because obviously it still shows it as being warped in the fog of war. So if he did not actually click on the building, then he would not be aware of what he is building and may have just assumed that it is a gateway or something similar, since they are similar size. But anyways, I was mentioning the reason he has the pylons along the outside of his base is because the new Nidus Worm technology for the Zerg players do not require them to build the worms on creep. So they can basically summon a Nidus Worm anywhere they have vision. So if that starts to come up, The Protoss player has these pylons along the outside of his base so he can actually see that before the worm pops. Because if you can kill the Nidus worm before he actually sends any units through it, then that effectively stops the ability for him to transport units into your base directly. So another gateway and assimilator going down for Hasu now. So he has got a healthy amount of probes mining on minerals and gas. And it looks like Dimaga getting this expansion up and running here right now. He does have a queen out at the expansion and at his main, so going to be able to macro up pretty effectively using that spawn larva. And then also, if he does have any energy extra or save any energy, he'll be able to spawn some creep tumors to expand the creep for his base, which you can see he started to do out here. Expanding the creep for the Zerg player is super crucial now, because the creep gives you a speed bonus for movement for any ground units that are moving on the creep. So, in case you didn't know that, that is something that can be very, very key, especially when you're trying to chase down zealots that may have charge or something like that, because it gives you a little bit extra speed boost. And the first Void Ray coming out for Hasu now, and there's very little anti-air capabilities right now for Dimaga. He's got his two queens, but a queen can take on cannot take on a Void Ray 1v1. A queen will get taken down. He did just finish his Hydralis Den, though, so he's going to be cranking out some Hydras really quick here, trying to catch up. And it looks like there are some... the Queen is going to get held up by this Phoenix, because the Phoenix is able to use that gravity effect there. As you can see, where it lifts the ground unit up, that ground unit becomes rendered ineffective. It's not able to do anything, and it looks like he might be able to hold off this Void Ray. Barely getting the Void Ray, running the Queen away, and getting those Hydralis out just in time to save that second Queen. So he does still have one Queen, which is very important. The Queen very low on health, though, at 28 hit points, so I'm sure he's building another one. Yeah, you can see right there, building another Queen already. And this Phoenix is going to try to get off some harassment on the Overlords. The Phoenix is the new anti-air unit for the Protoss, if you have not seen it yet. It is pretty effective against most air I've seen, although I do not see them used too often. It was kind of cool to see the Graviton being used there, because again, not an ability that people have used a whole lot in the beta, at least not from my experience. And it looks like we're going to see a little bit of a battle here. Hydralis and Zerglings going up against a Zealot and Stalker army, primarily with one sentry. Although it looks like Hasu is going to back off and retreat, since he does have a sizable amount of Hydralis to go against here. And this one Phoenix, again, roaming around through the Zerg base, trying to find some Overlords and might be able to pick off, taking one shot there, but then backing off. Of course, a lot of Hydralis in the base of Dimaga right now. Going back to Hasu's base, he is going to be getting a robotics base, so he will be able to build Colossi out of his robotics facility if he so chooses, which Colossi do a good amount of splash damage against pretty much all Zerg units, so very, very effective against the Zerg ground army. And it looks like we may see another clash here. Hasu trying to get up his expansion. He's got a pylon and a couple cannons here setting up to take this expansion, which would even him up with the Zerg player. And so far in StarCraft 2, it seems like the Zerg player can keep up more or less, at least in the early game, off of one base. Although later in the game, two base becomes very important. So, staying one base ahead of the Protoss player becomes very important. So he will want to expand here not too long once Hasu gets this base up. Although he is macroing up a pretty decent sized army here. And he looks like he may be going for the high yield minerals here, taking down the destructible rocks here. And he already does have creep expanded all the way out past this base, so he will get the speed bonus, which will allow him to effectively move armies between his main expansion and the secondary expansion that he's trying to get up right now. And it looks like the Protoss army trying to see if they can find a way to get in here and attack from the right angle, although it doesn't seem that he is going to go for it. So backing off right now and beginning to warp in a few more units. As far as the tech pattern goes, it looks like the robotics bay is finished, and there is a Colossus coming out right now, and it looks like he has an observer queued up to come after that, so going to be using that observer to do a little bit of scouting here. And it looks like Dimaga moving up some spine crawlers. Of course, if you didn't know this, you can actually uproot a spine crawler once it's been built, which is like the new Zerg sunken colony, and you can actually move and burrow it, as you see here right now, which is what Dimaga's doing. I've never actually seen this used offensively as of yet, although Dimaga is very effectively moving his creep forward. You can see that he has taken over a nice chunk of the map here. And as he moves his creep forward, he is limiting the ability of the Protoss player to build further out, because obviously he cannot build on any of this creep. Although at this point, not affecting Hasu too much, because I have not seen many Protoss players actually building buildings this far out of their base. So at this point, it looks like he's just trying to get up the second expansion, and he does have the Colossus on the high ground. And he has not yet started upgrading the range upgrade for the Colossus, although it does look like He is going to move this Colossus out and try to do some damage here. Although he needs to be careful because this thing can get trapped very quickly by these Hydralisks. And the Colossus getting sniped by the Hydras and Zerglings. That is a big loss for the Protoss player this early in the game. So he is building two more, but of course, as you get more Colossus, that... and I'm not sure exactly what all those numbers are about, but as you get more Colossus, they become increasingly difficult to deal with.